Now students, today we will discuss about equivalent fraction. Now students, so first we will little discuss about fraction. So fraction is a number written in the form of numerator and denominator. So here, there is a equal to numerator and b equal to denominator, and in the middle of this small dash is known as fraction bar. So we read out this number as a upon b. A and b are separated with a fraction bar that also indicate division. The top number is called the numerator a and the bottom number is called the denominator b. The denominator can never be zero. Now students, now we will discuss equivalent fractions. The definition of equivalent fraction: equivalent fractions are fractions having the same values. It can be obtained by multiplying both the numerator and the denominator of the given fraction by the same non-zero whole number. Now here we take one example here. For two equivalent fractions of 1 upon 4. So now, how we get these two equivalent fractions? So here we multiply 1 upon 4 by the natural numbers. Like start with 2. Because if we multiply this 1 upon 4 by 1, so we get the same number 1 upon 4. So if we multiply 1 upon 4 first by 2, then 3. So then we get, because you all know that numerator multiply with numerator and denominator multiply with denominator. So in the first number, we get 1 2's are 2 and 4 2's are 8. So here we get 2 upon 8, right? After that, when you multiply 1 upon 4 by 3, then we get 1 3's are 3 and 4 3's are 12. So we get 3 upon 12. So here we say that, therefore, two equivalent fractions of 1 upon 4 are 2 upon 8 and 3 upon 12. Like if you find the other fraction or a next fraction of 1 upon 4, so we multiply 1 upon 4 by 4, then 5, then 6 and so on. Now after that, here we will discuss how to find the lowest term of the given fraction and how we reduce the given fraction. So to simplify a fraction to its lowest terms, divide the numerator and the denominator of the fraction by their SCF. So what we do here, we find the SCF of numerator and denominator. And after that, we will divide these both numbers, numerator and denominator, by their SCF. Now, the fraction is 12 upon 18. So, how we solve this fraction? So, here first we find the SCF of 12 and 18. And what is the SCF of 12 and 18? Is 6, right? So, after that, here we divide this 12 and 18 by 6. So, then how many times 12 divisible by 6? 2 times. And 18 divisible by 6? 3 times. So, here we get 2 upon 3. So, here we say that the simplest form, or here we reduce this 12 upon 18 in its simplest form, 2 upon 3. Now, comparing two fractions. So now, here we compare two fractions and the other and the more fractions. So here we use, if two fractions have the same denominators, right? If the two fractions having the same denominators, their values can be compared by comparing their numerators or by using a number. Okay. Now, so which has a greater value, 1 upon 5 or 3 upon 5? So in a solution, we say that, and here we compare numerators. The fraction having the greater numerator in these type of fractions, like where the denominators are same. So in these type of fractions, the greater numerator, the fraction having the greater numerator is the greater fraction. So if we say that 3 upon 5 is greater than 1 upon 5.
Now students, here we solve questions related to find next 5 equivalent fractions of each of the following. So now what we do here, we multiply numerator and denominator of this fraction, start with 2, then 3, then 4 and so on, right? So start with 2. 2 2's are 4 and 3 2's are 6. then 2 upon 3 multiply by 3, 2 3s are 6 and 3 3s are 9. 2 upon 3 multiply with 4, 2 4s are 8 and 3 4s are 12. Then 2 upon 3 multiply with 5, 2 5s are 10 and 3 5s are 15. Then 2 upon 3 multiply with 6, 2 6 are 12 and 3 6 are 18. Right? So if we say that these all are next 5 equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? So here we write 2 upon 3 is equal to 4 upon 6, is equal to 6 upon 9, is equal to 8 upon 12, is equal to 10 upon 15, is equal to 12 upon 18. We solve the second part of this question, 1 upon 5. Now, so here we multiply 1 upon 5, multiply by 2, then 1 2s are 2 and 5 2s are 10. Then 1 upon 5, multiply by 3, 1 3s are 3 and 5 3s are 15. Now 1 upon 5, multiply by 4, 1 4s are 4 and 5 4s are 20. Then 1 upon 5, multiply by 5, 1 5s are 5 and 5 5s are 25. Then 1 upon 5, multiply by 6, 1 6 are 6 and 5 6 are 30. So now here we write 1 upon 5 equal to the other equivalent fraction of 1 upon 5, 2 upon 10, 3 upon 15, 4 upon 20, 5 upon 25 and 6 upon 30. So now, why we call these all fractions are equivalent? Because if we reduce these all fractions in its simplest form, like if we reduce this 2 upon 10 in its simplest form, like 2 1s are 2 and 2 5s are 10. So here we get again 1 upon 5. And if we reduce this fraction, 3 upon 15, 3 1s are 3 and 3 5s are 15. So in these all fraction, when we reduce these all fraction in its simplest form, here we get 1 upon 5. So we say that these type of fractions are known as equivalent fractions. And what are the next equivalent fractions of this 1 upon 5? 2 upon 10 equal to 3 upon 15 equal to 4 upon 20 equal to 5 upon 25 and equal to 6 upon 30. Find the simplest form. A part of this question, 15 upon 75. So now students, when we find the simplest form of the fraction, so there are two methods. First, you divide these two numbers with the same number, which divide these number at the same time, or we also find the, we use another method where we find the first SCF of these two numbers, numerator and denominator, and after that we divide these two numbers by their SCF. So here first we find the SCF of these two numbers, 75 divided by 15. So 15 5s are 75. And we also, by observing these two numbers, we also say that these two numbers are divisible by 15. 15 1s are 15 and 15 5s are 75. So here we get 1 upon 5. And we also use the SCF of these two numbers, because the SCF of these two numbers is equal to 15. So if we divide these two numbers by their SCF, and we get 1 upon 5. Now here we solve B part of this question. So now 42 upon 28. So now here, first we find the SCF of these two numbers. So here we divide greater number by smaller number. How many times 42 divisible by 28? One time, right? So here we write 28. Ones are 28. Now here we subtract these two numbers. 12 minus 8, 4. And 3 minus 2, 1. After that, here we write 28 here. How many times 28 divisible by 14? 14 to the 28, right? So here we get 14 as a large divisor, and you all know that the large divisor is the LCF of these two numbers. So here we divide this 42 and 28 by their LCF. So here we divide these two numbers by 14. Now 14 threes are 42 and 14 twos are 28, right? So here we get 3/2. Now students, here we solve the first question from exercise number 7.3. Write the fractions. Are all these fractions equivalent? So here first we write the fraction form of these all pictorial form, and after that we compareize these all four fractions, these all are equivalent or not. So first, what is the fraction of the shaded part? 1/2. This part 2/4, then 3/6, then 4/8, right? The shaded part, total shaded part 1, and what are the total number of parts here? 2. Now total shaded part 2, total parts 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Total shaded parts 3, 1, 2, 3, and total parts 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then total shaded parts 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and total parts 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now after that, if you reduce these all fractions in its simplest form, if we get 1/2, so if we say that these all fractions are equivalent, right? So if we write 1/2, then we reduce this fraction to 1s are 2, 2s are 4, then here we get 1/2. Then if we reduce this fraction, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, then again we get 1/2, then 4 1s are 4 and 4 2s are 8, then again we get 1/2 here. So if we say that these all fractions are equivalent because these all fractions having the same values, 1/2. Okay, so these all fractions are equivalent, right? Okay, so the second question is write the fractions and pair up the equivalent fractions from each row. So what you do here, first we write the fraction form of these all shaded parts, right? In this row also, and after that, we match these figures with the other figures, and you solve this question in the book only. Okay, so you match these figure with the other figures which having the equivalent value, and we say that these are the equivalent fractions. The third question of this exercise 7.3, replace this blank box in each of the following by the correct number. So now here we write this number here, 2/7 equal to 8/ this blank box here. So now if we observe these numbers, so what numbers we multiply with 2 and then we get 8 here, and how many times 8 come in a table of 2? 2 fours are it, right? And here we choose another method also. If we divide this 8 by 2, how many times 8 divisible by 2? 4 times, right? So here the number is 4 which multiply with 2 and we get 8 here. So here 2 fours are 8 and 7 fours are 28. So in this blank box here we write 28, right? So the fraction is 8/28, right? Now after that, here we solve the second question here. So here we write 18/24 equal to this blank box upon 4. Now this 24 divided by a number and it give 4 quotient as a quotient, right? So what is the number? So if we divide this 24 by 4, so how many times 24 divisible by 4? 6 times, right? So if we say that, here we divide the both number, numerator and denominator, by 6, right? And then we get 6 fours are 24, and how many times 18 divisible by 6? 3 times, 6 threes are 18 and 6 fours are 24, 3/4. So here we write 3 in this blank box. Now students, you will solve the left part of this question, B, C and D part by yourself in your fair notebook. So now after that, here we solve question number 4. Find the equivalent fraction of 3/5 having denominator 20. So we form this question same as like in the previous question. So here we write 3/5 and
we find equivalent fraction which having denominator 20, right? So here we observe these two numbers, these two fraction numbers. So what we multiply with 5 and then we get 20 here. And how many times 20 come in a table of 5? 5 fours are 20, right? And we also check by using this method, if we divide this 20 by 5, how many times it is divisible by 5? 4 times, right? So here we multiply 3 upon 5 by 4. And then we get 3 fours are 12 and 5 fours are 20. So the equivalent fraction of 3 upon 5 when we get the denominator 20 is 12 upon 20. Now we solve the D part of this question. Numerator 27. Okay. So now here we form the same question like 3 upon 5 and here is numerator 27. Right. And we find what comes in this blank box. Now. So what number will we multiply with 3 and then we get 27 here, and simply we divide this 27 by 3. So how many times 27 divisible by 3? 3 9s are 27, right? So here we multiply this 3 upon 5 by 9. 3 9s are 27 and 5 9s are 45. So if we write 45 and we get equivalent fraction of 3 upon 5 with numerator 27 is 27 upon 45. Now students, you will solve B part and C part of this question by yourself in your notebook. Okay, and you also solve question number 5. Question number 5 in your homework by yourself, because these all questions are having the same concept, right? Now students, after that, here we solve question number 8. Question number 8 is, Ramesh had 20 pencils, Silu had 50 pencils and Jamal had 80 pencils. After 4 months, Ramesh used up 10 pencils, Silu used up 25 pencils and Jamal used up 40 pencils. What fraction did each use up? Check if each has used up an equal fraction of her or his pencils, right? Now, after that, first we write the given values here. So the total pencils Ramesh had equal to 20, Shilu had equal to 50 pencils, Jamal had 80 pencils, right? Now here we write fraction of used pencils. So first we write fraction of used pencil by Ramesh. So here we write 10 upon total pencils, used pencils upon total pencils. Then we write Silu, 25 upon 50 pencils. Then Jamal, 40 upon 80 pencils, right? So dear students, if you observe these all fractions here, and if you reduce these all fractions in its simplest form, so we get 1 upon 2, then 1 upon 2, and then 1 upon 2, right? 10 1s are 10, 10 2s are 20, 25 1s are 25, 25 2s are 50, then 40 1s are 40 and 40 2s are 80. So here we get the same value of these all fractions here, right? 1 upon 2. So if we say that hence each has used up an equal fraction of pencils. Okay, is equal to 10 upon 20 is equal to 25 upon 50 is equal to 40 upon 80 and is equal to 1 upon 2. Right? Now students, you will solve the left part of question number 4, 5, 6 and 7, and you also solve question number 9. So you will solve these all questions in your FAIR notebook.
Here we will discuss like and unlike fractions. What are the like fractions? Because these both topics are related to our previous classes and previous chapters also, and previous classes, sorry. So like fractions, what are the like fractions? Fractions with the same denominator are called like fractions. Like if there is a set of fractions are given here, and if the denominators are same in these all fractions, so if we say that these all are like fractions, like 2 upon 13, 5 upon 13, 7 upon 13 and 12 upon 13 are like fractions, because these all fractions are in the same denominator. Now the second one is unlike fractions. Fractions with the different denominators are called unlike fractions. Example like 3 upon 17, 2 upon 13, 8 upon 19 and 4 upon 15 are unlike fractions, because these all fractions have different denominators, like 17, 13, 19 and 15. So these all are different. So if you say that these type of fractions are known as unlike fractions. Now after that here we solve some questions related to like and unlike fractions, and we compare two different fractions and we say that which one is greater out of these two given, and we also arrange these fractions in ascending order by using this concept like and unlike fractions.